Butter? Is that butter?
Welcome to our 1 hour live finale of the first season of College Life. I'm Brooke Baer.
I'm Christine Uhas.
I'm Ryan Knutson.
And I'm Tyler Stricker. Today we're going to be taking some time to reminisce about our favorite moments on the show and play some of our favorite games, just like last time. So grab some popcorn because we got a full hour episode of Sea Life coming your way.
It's College Life with Tyler Stricker. Brooke Baer. Ryan Knutson. Christine Uhas. In Studio 2.
So normally we have a couple guests on the show to hear about their college experiences, but we figured for our finale, we could interview ourselves.
Yeah, after all, we're the host and producers of College Life. So we have a lot of varied experience, and we're super involved on campus and on Titan TV.
So I've got a couple of questions here for all of us to answer. Are you guys ready?
Yeah.
Of course.
All right. This is gonna be
feels weird to be on the other side.
Yeah. Okay.
So to start, we should describe all of our own personal college experiences, like our majors and what we are involved here at UWO. What we're involved in.
Let's hear
Tyler
start. Well, senior at UW Oshkosh. Graduating next week.
Congratulations.
Yeah, it's going to be fun. It's going to be exciting. I'm nervous. It's going to be great, you know, moving on next step.
But yeah.
Anyways, I'll get back to the question. Radio, TV, film major, journalism minor. I was actively involved in radio, TV, film right from the start. Titan TV, helping out with sports. I was a sports director junior year. WRST, helped out with Oshkosh Sports Saturday. Hosted the sports page a couple times, had a jazz shift. I mean, it was a blast. I was really involved with the stuff on in the radio, TV, film major. So.
How about you, Ryan?
This may be shocking, but I'm a radio, TV, film major.
I think we all are, but like, I love minors.
And my minor's also in journalism, so we're twinsies.
Twinsies.
Yeah.
You're also graduating.
Yep, I'm also graduating. Ooh. And for me, I took a little different road. I did my first 2 years at a technical college, and then I came here. I did two more, and then this is my bonus year.
Yeah.
I'm glad I could spend it with all you guys.
Hey, there you go.
Nice.
For me, most of my time has been doing stuff in front of the camera here, both on Sea Life and on narrative shows. Like, I was on the sketch comedy show, Comedy Kosh. I was on the drama, Rosemary Park, and I was on the other drama, which aired this season, Achieve It. I've had some great times getting to know everybody, both in the studio setting and in the field setting.
Yeah, for sure. I'm an RTF major, too. I'm a music industry minor, though.
So nice.
Mixing it up.
I was involved here. I'm the executive producer on this show. Besides that, outside of RTF, I do, like, comedy club, and I used to play rugby for 2 years.
We saw Christine, disclaimer, we saw Christine at her comedy club down in Titan Underground.
It was hilarious.
Killed it. You're good. You're really good. Yeah. It was funny. It was so funny.
All right, what about you, Brooke?
I am also a radio, TV, film major, surprise. I do have a double minor in business and communications, so
nice.
Keeping me busy. Let's see, yeah, Titan TV, pretty much just all the whole RTF program, you know. From sophomore year, though, I mean, freshman year, you know, it's kind of like
trying scary. To figure yourself out, right?
Yeah, I did study away in Colorado for a semester, and I was in the improv club. So that was pretty cool.
That is really cool.
You got the funny couch over here.
Yeah.
Funny.
Yeah. That's about it, you know.
Keeping
we're
it
all
real.
Super involved, though. Like, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, you gotta be.
We got another year.
We see each other around the building all the time.
Oh, yeah, so. Of course. Yeah. Probably too much.
Now it's gonna be empty. What are we gonna do? Yeah, you know, we're leaving. What are, how are you guys gonna...
How do you replace
Egg Boy?
How do you replace Tuesday?
Yeah, I'm sure we'll find a way. No,
all right, what else you got? Let's see. So, as Sea Life producers and hosts, we have proven to be very talented, but we also have some talents that we don't get to showcase here on the show.
Ooh,
so let's go around and name some.
I'll go first. I can do like a Chewbacca noise, but
do it.
Should I? Okay, it goes.
Do it.
So that's that. That's like one talent. Anyways, someone else go. Someone else go.
That was awesome.
Okay,
that
was good.
That's gonna be a tough one.
Someone else go.
Yeah,
I'm sorry. I've been pretty flexible in the past. I can't now.
Splits?
I can I used to be able to
do
put
some.
Both legs over my head.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh my God.
And
wow,
I get this like weird arm thing. I can't do it anymore. But so I used to be pretty flexible. So.
All right. What you got?
I don't know. Like, I used to be able to shove my fist in my mouth, but that's not really a talent. That's more disgusting. That's more disgusting
what?
Than anything.
That's a talent. That's a talent.
Yeah. It is.
Yeah. It's a very unique.
Those days are behind me, though.
Yeah, for sure.
All right, Brooke, let's wrap it up here.
I don't have any talent.
Yes, you do. Come on.
Oh, don't be bashful. Don't be bashful,
ride,
Brooke.
Like, used to ride.
Yeah, I do. Yeah, I used to like ride and race motorcycles, like dirt bikes.
That's not a
yeah.
talent. Okay.
For me to stand on two wheels is like,
on
you know.
The side. Okay. All right.
Yeah, you're good.
Well, to really get a sense of what it's like to be a producer on the show, we filmed this pack of a behind-the-scenes look. It's definitely interesting, so check it out.
Sometimes as the executive producer of Sea Life, I have to shut down the ideas that really suck around here.
And we have to get pinatas, but what are we going to fill the pinata with?
How about like a full turkey dinner? Ew. Gravy, stuffing, mashed potatoes.
Stuff like that. Sometimes I just ignore everybody else, and I just do what I want.
Oh, you know, sometimes here at Sea Life, I don't always trust people, so I have to take matters into my own hands and dress the set myself.
Okay, so for the cooking segment, we're doing Sundays.
Hey guys, I set up the set. It's good to go.
Looks good. Looks real good.
All news is good. A Sea Life. They reek of desperation and mediocrity.
Does he know we're in the room, Christine?
Yeah, Steven, who are you talking to?
You know, I really try my hardest to be nice and just get everything done. It's...
What?
Oh, good stuff.
Ryan, have you been here the whole time?
Hey, buddy.
Where did you think I was? I've been here writing! What? It's hard to write a de-stress segment when you're stressed!
Well, is it done?
Almost, we need to get interview questions. All right, well, we'll see you at 3.
Good luck. Yep. Better be done.
Yeah, let's go get some food.
How about smoothies?
Oh. Yes. Yeah.
Or naps.
Or nap.
Hey, buddy, how's the editing going?
It's going good. Let's get it done.
All right, just get it done faster. Bye.
It's day 13. It's about 2:30 in the morning. Haven't shaved in a week. All I do is edit. And they treat me like crap.
Guys?
Yeah.
Guys?
What?
Can I go?
Is the video done?
Can I get food at least?
I'll shove a granola bar under there later for you.
What? Can I get water?
Hey, we gave you a pee bucket already. What more could you possibly want?
Let me out of here!
All right, Steven, do you know how to work this printer?
No.
Can you seriously just help me work this? I can't. I don't.
No.
Steven, I'll do anything.
No.
I'll even help you on news.
Did you turn it on?
Well, I think overall it's gonna be a pretty good show.
Yeah, I'm feeling pretty good about it.
It should be pretty decent. Pretty solid. All
right. Well, let's break down one last time.
All right. Let's go. All
right. Sea Life on 3. 1, 2, 3.
Sea Life.
I can promise you that being a producer on this show is rarely boring. We have a lot of laughs, and we actually like hanging out with our news director, Steven.
And when we come back from this break, the four of us are going to be competing in a few of our favorite games, including Trivia and Chill.
Woo-hoo.
So stay tuned for more Sea Life.
So we drowned the fire.
Yep.
Stirred it.
Mm-hmm.
Drowned it again.
Mm-hmm.
And now just feel if it's cold.
Yeah.
Cool.
Smokey just gave me a bear hug.
I know. I already posted it.
The smallest moments can have the biggest impact on a child's life. Take time to be a dad today.
Right, mi cariño. So like I said, everything I learned about cooking, I learned from grandma's empanadas. Shall we go again?
Yep.
Mix the beef with the onions with the peppers with the paprika, the paprika, the garlic with the oregano with the cumin. Got it?
Got it.
Throw in the olives, stir, season, stir again, pour out the flour, roll out the dough, make a circle, drop in a fistful of filling, fold over, press down, and ta-da!
Most parenting is hard to do in just 2 minutes. But 2 minutes twice a day making sure they brush is easier, and it could help save them from a lifetime of tooth pain.
Welcome back, guys. If you haven't seen us play this next game before, it was featured on our episode with the women's basketball team, and it is called Headshots. This game is really quite simple and quick. Brooke and I are going to wear these basketball hoop headbands, and we will act as the baskets. Meanwhile, Ryan and Tyler are going to try and sink as many shots as they can before they run out of balls. The teams this time around are hosting duo against hosting duo. So Ryan and I against Tyler and Brooke. Whenever you guys are ready and I get this on, we will start, all right?
All right. I'm excited.
You know who's the best, right?
Sharpshooters.
Okay.
Trying to figure out who's got it.
Steph Curry and Klay Thompson.
All right, ready?
Yeah, come on.
Wait, three, gotta win. Let's do a 3, 2, okay, one, go.
Okay.
Oh.
We can move, right?
Okay. Oh, right off the front rim. It went in, but it just... Hey, backboard!
You're not shooting in Brooks.
Okay? You gotta use the backboard. Oh,
yeah,
shit.
Use the backboard. Oh.
You think I'm not trying?
Am I the backboard?
There we go. We got two. Three.
I was better with the basketball team.
Is that one?
Yeah.
I feel like my head isn't level there.
Oh, I went off the inside. Oh!
Did it knock it out?
Yeah.
Oh my
dang
goodness.
It.
No.
Oh, that.
Oh,
oh! Oh, I thought that was.
I only got two. Okay.
Dang it.
We got three?
Yeah. Okay.
Bend over. This
one's just for pride. Yeah, this one's for pride. Oh,
there
so much go. For pride.
Is there one more? One more.
Oh, I got one more. Okay. Oh, this one's still
hit
for
it.
Pride. No!
Why do these.
You know what?
Sometimes right,
lean looks on your
three.
Side.
Three?
All right.
Did we win?
9 new case.
Yeah, well, it looks like Brooke and Tyler are the winners of Headshots.
If you don't know these next two games on College Life, then you need to go back and binge watch our whole season. We couldn't possibly film our last episode without trivia and chill.
Of course. Let's do it. Sit back down.
All right.
It was a nice try.
Got my chair here.
You guys did good. There's just like... everywhere now. All right. Let's go. We got this.
Oh, don't forget the lemons.
All right.
All right.
My goal is to not have to eat.
All right, as always, we are paired off into teams. So we'll be asking random trivia questions, and whoever gets the correct answer before time runs out will be the winner. But watch out, if you get a question wrong, you gotta eat one of those lemons
what?
Brooke's got.
Oh,
they are not fun.
Yeah.
So let's get started.
Stricker remembers from
played
last
once before, don't need it again. That
right.
was rough.
Are you guys going first?
Yeah, why don't we go
yeah.
first? So, how many people have been nominated for Best Screenplay and Best Actor within the same year? Is it 3, 5, 8, or 10?
You said 8 kind of weird, like you didn't want to give away the answer?
That's how she plays the game.
She's looking to see if I've got a tell.
Poker.
You're like, I see his tell.
Your call. You can go for 5.
5? Are you sure?
Yeah.
Final answer?
Yes.
You locked in?
Yes.
You're locked in? You
yes.
are wrong. It is 10.
All right.
Lemon up.
Lemon up.
At least, like, you know, you had it wrong too.
All right.
There you go. You guys got the dish.
Oh, my mouth's already watered. Oh,
like, you're like, okay, like, it's not that bad. And you're like, oh, it's really bad.
I'm so glad that's not us.
Yeah.
Okay, our question. How many red stripes are on the American flag?
I'm 6, 7, 10, or 13.
Come on, you're seven? Patriotic.
What?
Is it seven? Or is it 13?
No, it's 13.
Yeah, from 13 colonies.
Wait, red stripes.
No. Yeah, yeah.
Red stripes, yeah. Not all
see,
the stripes?
Because there's red stripes.
The
that's why I thought it was seven, because I think there's seven red, then the rest are white.
So
three,
six, wait.
Two,
all right, seven.
One.
Seven.
Yes.
Yeah! See, she's trying
see,
to trick
thinking,
us.
I just thought yeah. I said all. It's like 13, okay.
Yeah, yeah, I was like, right, oh, duh, and then no, it's not.
All right, your turn.
Oh, okay. Don't which don't NBA me. Team was created most recently?
Which
A, Dallas,
NBA team.
NBA team. A, Dallas Mavericks.
Yeah,
B, Minnesota Timberwolves. C, Portland Trailblazers. Or D, Phoenix Suns.
What was the first one?
Dallas Mavericks, Minnesota Timberwolves, Portland Trailblazers, Phoenix Suns.
I guess Minnesota. Is that B?
Sure.
Is that B?
Yes, Minnesota Timberwolves.
B.
And that is correct.
Woo!
There you go.
Okay, good.
Saved yourself some lemons.
All right, do you want to read
there you go.
Yes. What is the currency in Japan? The Riki, the yen, the Japanese dollar, or pounds?
I'm pretty sure it's yen.
I think it's yen.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Look at this. I like our team. I like what we got going over here.
See, if I was on your team all year, we would have been fine.
All right.
We would have been undefeated.
There you go, yeah.
All right. What is Captain Crunch's first name? Our favorite breakfast cereal
mascot. Oh, I
think I know
this.
Adam, Ethan, Horatio, or Jonathan?
Wait, I definitely don't know.
Yeah.
I
thought
it was like
Kurt.
Who?
Adam, Ethan, Horatio, or Jonathan?
Jonathan.
Captain Jonathan Crunch, that's your final answer?
Wait, is it?
Yeah.
No, yeah, it is.
Yeah.
It is wrong. His name is Captain Horatio.
Oh, it's good!
Lemon up! Lemon up! Alright, and while you guys do that, we'll figure out the winners. And doesn't take a whole lot of math to know that Ryan and I. We're definitely winning. I mean, that's the face
yeah,
of
that. No one
loss.
Makes that face when they win.
So, congrats, Ryan.
Yes,
what a good
yes,
job.
Yes.
What a good job. The overall running total for the most wins of Trivia and Chill on the show goes to host Ryan and Christine. So, you get a little bit of a small
yeah,
win.
At least,
so, there you go.
There we go.
Congratulations.
Champions.
Not that bad.
There you go.
Another quick game has become a classic here. It's called Fast Facts.
Yes.
So this is one of my favorites because it is so random and informative. Pick questions out of the bowl and answer them honestly, no matter how ridiculous they are.
All right, am I gonna pick one and we all answer it?
Sure.
That,
I like that,
that
idea,
yeah.
That's good.
Oh, there's a green one.
Ooh, this one has to be
what was your biggest childhood fear?
Spiders, and they still are.
Yeah, spiders.
I think the dark of the basement, you know?
Yeah, for me.
I had it's a creepy basement, you know?
What I'm scared
and
of?
You hear a creak and a little thing.
And you freak
you
out.
You run upstairs.
Really? You know what I'm scared of? It's tripping up the stairs. It's a huge fear
actually,
of mine.
A huge fear of mine, too, is getting your fingers pinched in like a door.
Oh. Scary. I don't want to
I can't, like,
in
I can't reach
yeah.
the doors.
Yeah.
It's bad.
Would you be willing to eat a bowl of crickets for $40,000?
Yeah.
If they're cooked, I've already
bowl.
Had one.
A
so.
Bowl?
Yeah.
How big's the bowl? Well, let's just
you
assume
can, like,
it's
wash
an
it
average-sized
down.
Bowl.
I've had like one or two, so I could do a bowl.
Okay. Well, and that's
a lot.
Right, of
bowl.
That's a lot of money too. Like,
oh yeah, you can do a bowl.
Yeah, like sure. there's far
yeah,
worse things you can
totally
do for that
right.
much money.
Hey, we're in college. We need the $40,000. Think of this way: you can almost pay for school.
I need four bowls for that.
All right. Describe something that's happened to you which had no explanation. So it's just some crazy.
Oh man.
All right, real quick. I'll
go quick. I got one. So I'm in St. Louis and there's this guy going around. He's, you know, he's asking for some change. So I give him some change and then he comes into the restaurant we're eating at.
Yeah.
He takes out his teeth, refuses to pay,
what?
And he just leaves, but he forgot his teeth.
Oh.
So they had to come back and give him his teeth.
Oh.
That's
right.
The best
yeah.
one. You win right there.
Yeah.
That's
okay, one that gets it. Random.
All right, let's get a quick question here. What's your favorite center smell?
Scent or smell?
I like a good
ocean
breeze.
Ocean breeze? No. I like clean, like a lemon or like an orange. Oh,
yeah.
Orange?
Or oh. like freshly washed
yeah,
sheets.
You smell?
I like clean laundry.
Smells good. Taste?
That's
no, not too
all right.
much.
All right, so if you couldn't tell from this, we like to have a lot of fun here on College Life. From
yeah,
time
do.
To time. This past week, we got to go out and play with one of the campus's most fun new attractions, the Bubble Balls. Check this out, guys.
This is by far one of our favorite packs to film, and we definitely
oh,
had
yeah.
some quality bonding
yeah.
time running into each other, knocking each other over. These Bubble Balls were the best and totally built for us big goofballs
yeah.
on the show. Check it out.
What's up, Sea Life fans? We're at the Mansion at the Student Recreation Center playing Bubble Balls.
We're just going to hit each other and...
See what happens. And we're here with our news director, Steven, as well. He wanted to come hang out with Sealer. There it is. All right, let's get started. Let's do it.
Bubble ball. There are no rules. It's anarchy.
Good times. We want to give a big shout out to the rec center for letting us rent the bubble balls. We encourage anyone who thought that was fun to contact them and look into renting them for the day.
We have to take another quick break, but when we come back, we are talking all about summer.
Woohoo!
So don't change that channel, guys. This is Sea Life.
You guys, he wants us to grab the show faster. He's got a prompt.
Apples and bananas. I need to eat apples and bananas. Why can't I eat?
1 in 5 children struggles with hunger in America. Support the Feeding America nationwide network of food banks to help provide meals to those in need. Join us at feedingamerica.org.
Here's your check. You got it. You know, since I got rid of my car, I really enjoy walking.
Okay. Got it. No.
Getting pulled over for buzz driving could cost you around $10,000 in fines, legal fees, and increased insurance rates.
Oh, you're home early.
You live with your mom?
That'll set your game back a few years. Buzzed, busted, and broke. Because buzz driving is drunk driving.
They said I couldn't dream. Called me a piece of trash and swore that's all I'd ever be. Said a bottle couldn't see the ocean. Give up. Go back to the dumpster. But I didn't listen. I made my way. And now, I am what I've always wanted to be.
Welcome back to College Life. With summer approaching, that means classes are over for a couple months, and suddenly you have loads of free time. Christine and I have some great ideas what you can do with all that free time.
If you like music, then summer is a great opportunity to see some of your favorite bands play live. Make sure you check out some popular festivals like Warped Tour, Summerfest, and even Country USA right here in Oshkosh.
If you're broke and staying in Oshkosh this summer, getting a summer job is a must for plenty, and there's plenty of businesses out there looking to hire college students in the summer. Or you can look into getting an internship so you can advance yourself in your field of study. Summer's a great time to get ahead.
If you are an outdoorsy person, then make sure you Google some great places to hike in Wisconsin or even MapQuest the nearest beach and take a road trip. Take advantage of the nice warm weather while it is here.
Or if you just need a 3-month break to catch up on sleep, de-stress a little bit, and take some time to stay inside and catch up on all those wonderful Netflix shows, or whatever else you want to do with your free time, make sure to relax and catch up with your family and friends.
You heard what we are doing with our summer, so coming up, that's what we're doing. But we sent our co-host for one last Brooke and Tyler on the street package to see what the students of UWO will be up to in the coming months. Check it out.
We're 1 week away from graduation, and that means summer is right around the corner. And Brooke, we gotta ask some people what's going on. What's their summer plans?
Let's do it!
Summer. We're just talking about summer plans. Do you have any things major planned for the summer?
I don't actually right now. Maybe a trip to Florida, but other than that, nothing.
Do you like to surf or?
I'd like to try, but I never have.
Okay, cool. You gotta be careful of the sharks though.
I'm not too worried.
I plan to work during the summer.
Work during the summer? Where do you work?
At a play, a parky.
Park?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. So like a parking rent. Oh, not a parking rent, like a park with kids and.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Does anyone want to be interviewed? Anybody at all?
Working a lot. Family vacation.
Oh yeah, where are you going on vacation?
Prague.
Wow, yeah. That's a big trip.
Road trips, hopefully.
We are going to a concert. Where do you want to go for a road trip?
Colorado.
Latte. What do you like to do in summer? Me too. Long walks on the beach, that's my kind of pop.
I plan to go home, which is down by Platteville, so 3 hours south, and work at the nursing home as a CNA and work on my family farm.
Fantastic. Would you rather be stung by 3 bees or have really bad sunburn?
Really bad sunburn, because that thing will go away eventually.
Oh, give me the bees.
The bees? Really? Wow. What if they were like
all three on your face?
I'll take it.
You don't like sunburn that bad? I don't mind sunburn.
Well, I'd probably the sunburn because I've lived through that before.
Yeah. Hey, then you get the tan after it too, so it works out perfect. Your freckle? Oh, dang it, that's too bad.
Really bad sunburn.
Yeah?
Yeah. I did marching band in high school, so I'm used to getting super sunburned because our season was during the summer, so I'm used to it, so it's not too bad.
Flip-flops or shoes?
Definitely barefoot.
Barefoot, so not even either. None. Yeah. None of the above. There you go. Hey, dude.
Shoes or flip-flops?
Flip-flops.
Okay. Why is that? You like to let the dogs breathe a little bit?
Pretty much.
Shoes.
Wow, that was no hesitation. Why do you hate flip-flops?
Well, when you're driving, you got your pedal and it always gets caught, and then you're like, oh my god, I'm gonna crash and die.
That's true.
And you never know when you're gonna have to run somewhere, and you got flip-flops on, you trip, fall. It's just bad.
Now, we all know the summer months can get really hot or even really cold. You never know with this Wisconsin weather.
You don't,
But one of our favorite ways to cool down when it is nice and hot out is some nice ice cream in the middle of summer.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to walk you through what are some of our favorite recipes for the perfect summer sundae.
All right, so I'll go first. I love vanilla ice cream that day. That's my favorite. So
yeah?
That's what I got. Yeah. So I'll just take some of this. This is super soft. That's good. Okay, so I'm going to take some of this. And then I really like chocolate chip cookie dough ice cream.
Yeah.
So that's, I bought a little chocolate chip cookie dough so I can make it at my house. So these are like covered in chocolate too, which is rare.
Well, and it's like nice when you do it yourself instead of buying like the pre-made one, because you can just put in as much like cookie dough as you
course.
Want.
Yeah,
like,
and I'm always a big fan.
Like, I don't like to show discretion when I'm eating ice cream. Like, I want to go all out.
Yeah.
Like, I'm already eating ice cream.
Exactly.
Just let me have this moment.
You gotta
let me have
out.
This moment.
And then the other thing I like is I love sprinkles. That's like my new favorite fad of an ice cream is sprinkles. So I just put a lot on, and then.
Now, do you call them sprinkles or jimmies? Because some people really like
calling
jimmies.
I know some people call them jimmies,
like,
but
oh,
I like sprinkles.
Jimmies.
All right, but that's mine. No, I'm basic. What do you do?
See, like, I like kind of that salty sweet combo. So,
okay,
like,
I got you.
I'll start with my ice cream here, and like, I'm just gonna take a big old glob.
Okay.
Yeah. Just look at.
There you go. There you
it's
go.
So big, right. It didn't want to come off the screen.
Yeah. What do you put on yours?
I'll take some like pretzels, or especially chocolate covered pretzels, so you can get that extra sweetness in. So just crumple those up, put them over.
There you go.
And maybe stick like a nice little pretzel like on top as like a little decoration. Like, yeah, look at that. How beautiful.
You're like making a masterpiece. I just threw that on there.
And then I was like this like hardening chocolate
syrup.
Yeah,
that's the best.
So like you gotta shake it up though, because like if you don't, it comes out like really bad.
Yeah, for real. All right, well, you just chug it too hard. All right, well, you do that. I can't wait to dig into these sundaes when we return. We'll
I'm already digging in.
On Brooke and Tyler next door in our other studio.
I heard they're planning to play Who's Quote, which is always entertaining. Stay tuned.
Nice.
I'm a teacher. Let me tell you what I make. I make learning a privilege, not a chore, and frustration a tool, not an obstacle. I make working hard seem easy and giving up impossible. I make an old subject feel like a fresh thought and unconventional methods common. I'm a teacher. I make more.
I have literally no idea how you did that.
Yeah? It's a good trick.
I'm going to trust you with something. And I'm a little, they're laughing, so I'm a little terrified right now because I've never met you.
What'd you do? Oh my god.
That's cool.
What?
How did you?
A great guy. I mean, look at him. What a sweetheart. Attaboy. Wait, Todd, what are you doing? How totally selfish and un-Todd-like of you. Come on, Todd. Come on, man.
She wants to achieve its status.
Joe's gone. You have to be Johanna now.
Welcome back to Sea Life. Instead of pulling an all-nighter and cramming to study before finals or any exam, we have a few simple study tips for you to manage your time and get the most out of your studying.
Number one, space it out. A new learning technique called spaced repetition involves breaking up information into small chunks and reviewing them consistently over a long period of time. Also, make a calendar with a list of your upcoming events, exams, and assignments. This will help you space out your work and make sure it gets completed.
Number two, take breaks. Research suggests studying the same stuff in a different place like a coffee shop or library every day makes us less likely to forget that information. Also, try taking a 10-minute walk or having a chat with a friend when you feel stressed. Breaks not only help improve your focus, but they can boost your productivity too.
Number three, switch it up. Don't stick to one topic, but instead study a bunch of different material in one setting so then your brain actually has time to think about what you're doing and you aren't just going through the motions. It can really help with your critical thinking skills.
Number four, rewrite your notes. Put those third grade penmanship lessons to good use. Research suggests we store more information securely when we write it down and put it instead of typing. Start by recopying the most important notes from the semester onto a new sheet of paper.
Number five, test yourself. It sounds like a strange thing, but sometimes simply entering an exam environment is enough to make you forget some of the things you learned. Testing yourself with regular quizzes is a great way of doing this. The more you practice, the better you'll become.
And finally, my favorite part about studying, don't forget to treat yourself. Every time you finish a page or a chapter in a book, go grab a candy bar or that cup of coffee you've been waiting for.
Well, we hope you're going to use these study tips the next time you're studying for that exam or writing that paper. These tips will help you get through the stressful times.
But if you need a break from taking notes and reading textbooks, we have got Ryan and Christine here to show you guys their crafty side. Check out these crazy crafters.
Today on Sea Life, the C stands for crafts.
So we're showing you guys some projects you can make from stuff that you find around your house.
We'll be making solo cup lights and construction paper bows.
So let's get started. All right, so first I'm gonna show you guys how to make the paper bow. What you're gonna need for that is construction paper or newspaper, magazines, any type of paper, a ruler, a stapler, some glue, a pencil, and some tape. So first off, you're gonna cut out some strips to make the bow. So you're gonna need 9 strips total. They're gonna be 3/4 inch thick. And 3 of them will be 12 inches, 3 will be 11 inches, 2 of the strips will be 9 inches long, and the last strip, will be 4 inches long. So you're gonna measure all those out and cut all your strips out of whatever kind of paper you guys use. And then after that, you take each individual strip and you take the ends and you fold them towards the center, but you make kind of a loop. It shouldn't be flat. You make a loop with it on one side and then you make a loop with the other side. And then once you get both of them lined up in the middle, you're gonna staple them together, and then that's your first loop and that's done. So you're gonna do that with all the strips, and then once you've made all of those loops, the only last thing to do is to assemble it. So you take the 3 biggest loops that you have, and those are gonna be your base. So you lay those out so they're all sitting next to each other and they're all on top of each other in the center. So all the centers should be lined up. And then you're gonna glue all those together. Make sure you hold it for a couple seconds so it stays together and it doesn't fall apart on you. After that, you take the 3 next shortest strips, you do the same thing with that, and then you take the last 2, and then the very shortest last little bow that you have, that's gonna be the centerpiece. So you take all of those and you glue them together and you just hold it down, and you should have a perfect bow. It'll look awesome. And that can be the bow that you put on gifts, or that can even be a gift in itself because they're pretty cool.
Oh, hi there. I was just playing with my cups. So today we're gonna be using said cups to make cup lights. So for this project, you're gonna need some plastic cups, a hot glue gun, scissors, and of course you're gonna need some sort of string light. The first step to this project is gonna be you're gonna take your cup here and your scissors and puncture a hole in the bottom of your cup. Once the hole is punctured in the cup, it's ready to put your light on in. So you just feed that through the back of the cup where you have that hole. All right, and we're all done. And remember, if you want to have this with a more secure hold, just take your hot glue gun and do a little dab there, 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 and there. And you got perfect lights. You're styling.
I will definitely have to start looking around my house for some more potential household items to make crafts with. If you like those ideas and you want to check out more, check out our Facebook page.
And before we go into our break, we're playing one more game, just Brooke and I are playing, and it's been featured before, and it's a fan favorite. Whose quote is it anyway? We each have cards with quotes on them from famous actors in 2 movies that they starred in. The goal is to correctly match the quote with the right movie. Whoever gets the most right wins. So, Brooke,
right,
I believe you're the one to start.
Yeah. So, is it from the Sandra Bullock movie, The Lake House, or Speed 2 Cruise Control? I'll swear, I'm never leaving the house again.
Lake House.
No, incorrect.
I'm sorry, I really don't know Sandra Bullock's movies. I'm just trying.
What a
tried
shame.
So hard. It is, she's a good actress.
All right, what
is
you
it from the Ryan Gosling movie, Crazy Stupid Love, or The Notebook?
Ooh,
I don't know whether to help you or euthanize you.
The Notebook.
No.
Dang.
Crazy Stupid Love. Was it because I said it?
Confident.
Was it because
yeah.
I acted
the
a little bit?
The way you said it, I was.
Some people say I look like Ryan Gosling.
I don't see it.
No people say that. Anyways.
All right. On that note, is it from the Tom Hanks movie, Captain Phillips? Good movie.
It is.
Or You've Got Mail.
Okay.
The problem is not me talking. The problem is you not listening.
You've Got Mail.
No, Captain
no.
Phillips.
No. Oh, shoot. I should have thought that
yeah.
through. I know both of those movies. I should have thought that through. I knew that answer. Is it from the Leonardo DiCaprio movie, The Great Gatsby, or The Wolf of Wall Street? Let me tell you something. There's no nobility in poverty. I've been a poor man. I've been a rich man.
The Wolf of Wall Street.
Yeah, that was.
Yeah.
That one was.
All right.
Gave it right to you.
All right. I'm in the lead. Just letting you know.
Yeah, barely.
All right.
Is it from the Emma Stone movie, The Amazing Spider-Man 2, or Zombieland? I'm sorry, I didn't take the bus to the Bahamas of Hiding Places. Yeah. What do you think?
Zombieland?
No, Spider-Man.
It's like you're like giving me like hints like, oh, it should definitely be this movie, but it's, you're like throwing me curveballs. I don't like it.
Well, is it? It looks like I'm the winner.
Oh, okay.
And after the break, Ryan and Christine are joining us here to play a new game and behind the scenes to show you guys. So, stay tuned for some more Sea Life.
There's one thing you can never have sex without.
It's not something you buy.
Or something you take.
In fact, there's only one way to get it.
It has to be given to you, freely.
It's consent.
Because sex without it isn't sex.
It's rape. Consent.
If you don't get it, you don't get it. It's on us to stop sexual assault.
Learn how and take the pledge at itsonus.org.
Most party fouls are pretty dumb. But if you decide to drink and drive underage, you could lose your license and your freedom. Underage drinking and driving. The ultimate party foul.
Alvin and the Chipmunks want to remind you, bacteria can hide in food and make you ill.
Wow.
But you can keep bacteria from ruining your day with four simple steps. Clean.
I'm waiting for the ring cycle.
Separate. Cook. And chill.
We chipmunks are notoriously tidy.
Check your steps. The road trip to food safety starts at foodsafety.gov.
Titan TV News has you covered.
We have all the stories that matter to the community, both on and off campus.
And we'll keep you up to date with all your Titan TV sports action and big sports headlines across the state.
You can watch Titan TV News live every Friday at 4 p.m.
on Titan TV.
And welcome back to College Life. We're trying out a new game since we're here in Studio 2. It's called Green Screen.
Yeah, so Tyler and Christine have been picked to be in front of the green screen because they have both lost the most games here on Sea Life throughout the season. So this is a chance for them to redeem themselves. They will stand in front of the green screen as a video plays.
They can't see or hear the video that's being played, but we'll try and give them some clues so they can have an idea to guess what's going on. Whichever of them guesses correctly will win. Are you guys ready over there?
Yeah, of course.
Definitely. We have no idea what's going on. We have no idea what's going on.
All right.
You guys look like a two goobers.
We are.
Yeah.
All right.
Well, what's going on here?
All right, so we're getting our first one ready for you.
Okay. We're getting ready. We're dancing over here.
Hang tight.
Are you guys excited?
Yeah. We're just getting loose over here.
What's the place that you are most afraid that it could be?
Spiders. If it was only spiders, probably.
Like a cave, yeah.
All right, so you're at this place. There's lots of fancy stuff there.
You're
a restaurant.
You're like a buffet. You're like important people.
A buffet?
We're kings.
You're like VIP. Washington, D.C.
We're at a concert.
No. Some of my favorite people would be there.
Yeah.
The Academy Awards. Emmys.
More specific.
Your
favorite. It's part of the show.
Yeah, you walk on something
music.
Red.
Oh, red carpet. The red carpet.
For the
Emmys. The Grammys.
Oscars.
Emmys. I don't know.
There you go.
The Oscars.
You got it.
Okay.
All right, so Tyler gets that first one. Tyler has the first
one. All right, Tyler.
I got to get more involved.
All right, so we're going to get this next one here
ready.
Maybe
I got to feel it a little bit there.
Are you guys ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
You guys ready?
All right, I'm not going to look at
you guys.
Pumped up
now?
Yeah, we're ready.
Yeah.
I'm just going to take it all in.
Christine, you get ready. Get your game voice on. You're behind.
I'm behind by one.
You need to get there. You need to get one.
All right, I'm all stretched out.
Yeah, you can't let Tyler beat you.
I can't.
Come on.
I can't. Maybe I'll just like shove it away or something like that. Can't answer anymore.
Show me your happy face.
This is my happy face.
That's your
I'm
happy
super
face?
Excited because I'm going to kick Tyler's butt over here.
Why are you using your happy face? You need to have a game face.
Yeah, where's your game face?
We're trying.
You guys are totally not going to get this next one.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, they're so random.
Yeah, like we really worked hard on these.
We did.
We work so hard that they're having issues bringing their awesomeness behind you.
I've worked more on this than I've studied in the past week.
Oh, yeah? Well, that's good. I'm glad you put a lot
of time. It's definitely
but priorities, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Sea life is my number one priority.
Sea life.
Yeah, if there were spiders back here, I'd probably leave because I couldn't even do it if you were pretending.
Do you think you may have an idea where this next one may be? If you could have any place behind you right now, what would you have?
Yeah, where would you want
Disneyland.
Okay, this
like
place is
beach.
Not this is not Disney.
So I've never been to this place before.
Okay,
and it's somewhere that would be super cool.
It's not a place you want to raise your kids.
Yeah, it's like out of the country. It's
is it cold because I'm acting cold.
It will take your breath away.
It's out of this world.
Space.
We're in space.
More. It's a place in space.
Outer space. Moon. The moon. We're in Mars. We're gonna live
space
there
station.
One day.
It's space by station. The moon.
Mars.
I know.
Wait, did you say space station, Tyler?
Yes.
No, I said.
Shut up! I said space station. I practically
no,
lived
I definitely,
there.
I just, I'm not, I said space.
Can we float
space
away?
Station. I got
okay.
It. Yep.
It was a space
you guys
station.
Are tied.
We're gonna have this be a tie. Either way, you are both losers because you are the least winning people
well,
on Sea Life.
Oh, thank you.
I had now, even though we film the Sea Life live to tape, we do like to goof off a lot when we film packages. Here are some bloopers throughout the season.
This is Leonardo. He's our fearless leader.
That's nothing.
Let's light him up.
Raphael, sick of cuddly teddy bear. If big cuddly teddy bears were incredibly violent.
That's how I roll. That's how you roll.
Donatello, he's.
Wow.
What's the rundown? What's next?
One fireball for 50 cents.
What's your color?
It's blue.
Oh, the best behind
me. Oh, mine's purple. I don't think we can be friends now. Yeah.
Baloney has a first name, it's a S-E-A-R. Baloney has a second name, it's
a
I love to eat it every day, and if you ask me why, I'll say.
Ask me anything?
What's your major?
I'm a radio TV film major. Hence the camera.
Yeah.
Well, that was not going on. Hey, what's up, guys?
Maybe I'm just funny looking, huh?
Ready? You ready? All right, if you had to be a Ninja Turtle, what Ninja Turtle would you be?
I don't even know the names of the Ninja Turtles.
What's your favorite pizza topping?
Onions.
Then you'd probably be the Onion Ninja Turtle.
Now they're made out of this. Whatever this is. I'm not a bowling expert.
Am I holding this right? Is this how I'm supposed to do it? This doesn't feel natural.
God.
Wow.
That was it. That's us for bowling.
Signing off. Back to the studio to break it down. Oh, it's been good times here,
Sea Life.
Like so for the finale, we thought we'd go out with a bang, or at least a pinata. So we bought this little guy here and named him Turk, short for turkey,
of course, turkey.
Yeah, we thought we would just take turns swinging at him until he explodes with candy. I mean, let's be real. That's all pinatas are for. So who's up first? Brooke, I think you're
no,
mine.
Oh, no.
I think you should go first because you were.
He lost most of
yeah,
the game.
Yeah, he lost.
Yeah,
you're right.
Go easy on
the
little
what if I break it on the first one? I'm not going to
well,
break it on
I
the
first one.
I don't think you're that strong.
I think I'm going to get hit.
All right, ready? Here we go. 3, 2, 1.
Did it? Okay.
No. I got a good deadline, though. Here we go.
All right, who's up?
You go next. We got to have the biggest losers go
first. I'm lefty,
first.
So maybe biggest you guys losers. Should watch
Oh, yeah, we should watch Don't hit me.
Give it a good give it
I
a
even
good,
swear.
A good whack.
Oh, okay, I got the back of it.
All
right, let's do this. I'm so sorry, Turk. I don't mean to do this.
Sorry, Turk.
You never deserved it. Watch out, right?
Oh, he's on the ropes.
His neck's about to snap.
Watch out. Don't hit his right.
He's angry.
Okay.
Who wants to take it? Who wants to swing?
All right, Stricker.
Time to end this.
See what you got.
He looks so sad. Come on. Hit Turk.
You don't even get the kick. We just get the head.
Wait, let's see.
We just get the head.
I got him.
We got him.
Should we just rip him?
Hey, at least just put it on the floor.
Should we all just take a leg and rip him?
Yeah,
let's do it.
Oh, whoever gets the big wait.
This is like the worst. It's like the worst part.
Yeah,
ready?
First guy make a wish. For Turk. Cheers for Turk.
Cheers for Turk. Here you go, Turk.
Here's
Turk.
One.
Oh, oh my goodness.
All right. Well, exciting as that was, we've got one more break before we wrap up the show. This is College Life.
Hey.
Stay tuned.
Oh,
knee slap.
All
so we drowned the fire,
yep.
Stirred it,
mm-hmm.
Drowned it again,
mm-hmm.
And now just feel if it's cold.
Yeah.
Cool.
Smokey just gave me a bear hug.
I know. I already posted it.
The smallest moments can have the biggest impact on a child's life. Take time to be a dad today.
Right, mi cariño. So like I said, everything I learned about cooking, I learned from grandma's empanadas. Shall we go again?
Yep.
Mix beef with the onions with the peppers with the paprika, the garlic with the oregano with the cumin. Got it?
Got it.
Throw in the olive, stir, season, stir again, pour out the flour, roll out the dough, make a circle, drop in a fistful of filling, fold over, press down, and ta-da!
Most parenting is hard to do in just 2 minutes. But 2 minutes twice a day making sure they brush is easier, and it could help save them from a lifetime of tooth pain.
Welcome back, everyone. This week we have two photos a week for you. Our first one here is gonna be of our news director and us from when we were playing with the big bubble balls. We were exhausted, but it sure was a fun time. And right now we're having a blast here. We love our time here. We love playing with the bubble balls.
Yeah.
And our other photo of the week after this one, see, look how much of a good time we had there.
So much fun.
Like,
so exhausting.
They make a very comfy chair.
Yeah,
and
they do.
This next one is a shout out to our crew guy, Trevor. Thanks for helping us film the package.
The best.
He did good. You did your right job, man.
Always helping us out.
All right.
All right.
So, we're going to end the finale with some fun. Christina and I are going to give Tyler and Ryan a well-deserved makeover. We've got a bunch of dollar store makeup here, so we're going to try our best and try and make them look pretty.
We're going to try our best.
Nothing but the best for us.
All right. No promises.
I'm going to start with eyeshadow.
All right.
I'm not sure if I should.
Glasses come off for this little part here. But,
should we close our eyes for this?
Yes.
Or should we
yes, before? You definitely need to close your eyes.
Eyeshadow, so you should probably close.
Yes, I don't want to poke you.
Do I get a manicure and a pedicure here?
I don't know. Do you want like a blue or do you want, I'm going purple.
You go with what,
I'm not even letting
color?
Him pick.
What's my color?
So keep your eyes closed.
Oh my gosh, this is.
You're going to make you look like a pretty princess.
How are you going to do this?
I never would have
every
thought
day?
My last time
every day
on Titan TV I would be looking like this.
Well, you look so pretty,
Titan. Yeah, you look so pretty.
You look so pretty with purple.
Have you,
color,
purple's
girl.
My color. Are you, one another?
I can do one blue. Do you want one like darker?
No, do you have like two different colors on there?
Oh,
yeah, you gotta make them blend.
No. Have you put on makeup?
Oh, you look so good.
Sorry, coming back. Someone coming back.
Wow, is this like a first time thing?
You can't close them
like
more.
Well, I'm just trying
nice
to
yeah.
Nice.
Oh, Tyler, you look so
I'm,
good.
All I see is Tyler me. So Tyler me. I'm trying to get a
sarcasm, right?
No, you look pretty. I don't know what you're talking about.
Dude, this blend is
all right, moving to the other eyes.
Tyler, you only have brothers, right?
Yeah. Shout out to the brothers that are watching, because makeup for them.
Yeah,
and they get to see me at a weak spot.
Ready, I'm an only child, so this is all new to us. Like, we never had to, like, deal with sisters wanting to do
this.
Does that feel weird? I swear to God, if I open my eye, I'll probably die.
Yeah,
I'm giving you a wing.
Oh.
Girls love the wing.
Oh my god.
Tyler,
I'm gonna hit
it.
All right.
I'm gonna get. Oh my god.
Can you look up?
What do we got here? Mascara. All right. All right, so open your eyes. I'm gonna put some on your eyelashes.
Like how far down your
just normally.
And I win. I win.
Keep blinking.
How many times do I need to blink?
Oh, wait, keep going.
Tyler, you got eyeshadow in your.
This is a
you
pain.
Put in my, what did I do?
Yeah. Oh, all right, moving this eye. Keep blinking.
All right, we're doing wings again. You want a little Harry Potter screen?
Perfect, okay.
Oh my god.
I didn't ask for it. I just got a glimpse of you.
All right, oh pucker up. Oh. Pucker up, Ryan.
How are we doing here?
Go like oh, more like on, more like open your. You can open your eyes now.
Oh, so. Oh, I thought you were gonna say like.
Oh really? So
mouth.
Now you can go full fledged on this, huh? You're
oh,
really
yeah.
giving
oh,
me.
Oh look, I ran out of eyeliner. What color is this? So
oh, just you'll see.
Hey, a dollar only buys you so much, right?
I hope
right.
that's what they put on the label.
I'm not opening my eyes. And
oh, I got you.
Oh, you got my two. You got my.
I'm terrified.
You gotta look. Up.
You have to.
All right, now rub them together.
Not your whole.
Perfect.
Open your eyes and look.
Can I have the eyeliner?
I have them on.
My eyes feel right. heavier.
Oh, I didn't even do that.
Close your eyes.
Oh my god, right.
Tyler,
close
looking
your eyes.
At you, like you look like you came out of like the worst Lady Gaga concert ever.
The worst
like,
to
he
the
looks
best.
Good.
The worst. Like the concert was good, but the experience was
Tyler,
bad.
Tyler, I can feel you shivering. It's fine.
I'm terrified.
Your mascara looks good though. All right.
What about me, Tyler? Do I look?
I can't even open my eyes.
I'm oh. moving on.
I feel like you... they're chalk stuck full with.
Wait, we didn't even
look
do
like
it.
I'm catching
your
lipstick
right now.
Get back here. I can't do it.
Christine, what do you think he needs?
More eyeshadow.
More eyeshadow? Yeah, all right.
Just, wing
I'm
going to
add a little purple.
Oh, this is a really good color.
Oh, she's not even hitting her lips at this point.
All right, close the
we're
eyes.
Going for a, we're going for a real trendsetter look.
Oh, you just
I'm going for the rainbow look here.
All right, let me see. What do I need to... Okay, the eyeliner's a little off, but I'll...
I need a little more eyeliner, too.
I'm amazed
I'm so
that...
scared!
Christine,
look
I'm...
up, look up.
What do you need?
Oh, this is missing a problem.
Like, eyes, yep.
How are we doing? How are we doing on...
Christina, you're much better at applying it on yourself than you are on Tyler.
Very true. I'm also like behind him.
Well, that
so
means...
I, you know, Brooke's kneeling down and...
Gotta get the right angle.
Let's see. Now, I'm using their profile. We're doing a smoky eye, so everybody knows.
Yes, this is a smoky eye.
Tyler, you look good. Like,
so...
Yeah, you should go out, you
know,
go out to dinner like that
here,
sometime.
But you probably shouldn't hire Christine to do your makeup.
Hey now, hey.
And maybe, and to everybody out there, the two of us, we're single. We're single.
We are on the market.
I'm doing the smoky right now. You can't talk on this.
Perfect.
This is just too much.
Okay. I think. Tyler.
Oh. 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 Wait, hold on. Hold on here. Oh!
Oh, that's a Harry Potter?
You know what? I use the same color palette. So.
Hey!
Close your eyes.
Ryan, you're
Ryan
looking.
Just looks scared.
I don't know.
Like a little
how,
bit of the
like,
Joker with the lipstick kind of thing.
I think.
Okay, mine.
It looks
whoa.
Great.
What's this?
You both use pink.
That's.
Did you only buy pink? Was you the only one on? What am I getting? What is it?
Nothing. Close your eyes.
You got a smiley face there.
I'll just put my eyeliner on.
Man, that, I tell you
and
what.
Like the Harry Potter thing, like adds some.
No, putting the
you look
oh,
fabulous
the shit on the other foot, as you would say. This is difficult. Like, you guys
it's
do this all
easy.
The time.
Yeah, we do this like every day.
You know what?
Exactly.
It's, yes, you guys look beautiful.
Because you, know? You guys turn out well. Yeah. This on the other hand.
Let's do a close up of Tyler and a close up of Ryan. I'll look first, but I want one last look at the book. It looks so good. Look, yeah. A smoky eye, Harry Potter. Yeah.
See, I got you look like a clown.
All right, what about Ryan? Ryan looks like he's ready for a concert, like some punk.
Kesha concert.
Kesha and Lady Gaga, that's what
Ryan
we've got
this
time.
It looks like he's going
time.
To Harry Potter.
Awesome.
All right, as we wrap up the show, we want to thank everyone for who has tuned in to College Life this season.
Ooh, thank you, guys. We have enjoyed producing and hosting the show during the semester, and we hope you guys have enjoyed watching.
I'm getting it all over my glasses.
It's been a stressful show at times, but it's also been super fun. I couldn't think of a more rewarding experience than being here with you guys.
Absolutely. Yeah, so from all of us here in the studios and Titan TV,
this is College Life. Thanks right. again, guys.
You guys look good. You guys want? I think you guys deserve. Candy.
Yes.
I don't know if I can eat candy.
Yeah, no, you can't.
I'll get
a
smear.
Did you know that girl?